Namaste everyone, my name is Rishabh and I'm making this video on the request. A lot of people have asked me about the diet chart, what food they should eat to get nice results in the body. Weight loss or the food or diet is a very small part of the human body, and I have kept my notebook to not forget all the things that I want to say, so I've kept some key points there and to make you very much elaborate here. This video will be mainly about to tell you the tagline that I've thought in my mind would be the yogic science of the food that dietitians will never tell. Yes, the yogic science about the food that dietitians will never tell. And I'm talking about those dietitians who charge 1 lakh, 2 lakh rupees per sitting. So the idea is not about what you should eat. The idea is what is the nature of the food and its relationship with the human body. If you understand this thing very clearly, you will understand how this human body works. And this video will be very amazing if you listen to it completely and try to put all the logic things in that. If you listen to this completely, trust me, you won't need any dietitian in your life, okay? So we're gonna start with this video, everyone, and I'm gonna tell certain things that if your motive is to listen to video, you want to have a weight loss, if you have any kind of health issues, if you have asthma, thyroid, depression, PCOS and PCOD, constipation issues, migraine issues, everything is related to just one simple thing that I will tell in this video, okay? Many times that I've told that your life exists or your life moves with the prana. You breathe, you live, you don't breathe, you die. So all the science works around it. In yoga, the concept of the food is relationship with the human body is that body is made up of 5 elements of nature. In the Ayurveda also, the body comprises of 3 doshas, the vata, pitta, kapha. And the food and everything that relationship with it's that it's not about what should eat. It's about balancing the things with all these things that works along with this. 3 doshas have its own meaning. 5 elements of nature have its own meaning working inside. You need to understand that if you keep these things balanced in yourself, definitely you'll have a healthy body. Now let's talk about what is the nature of a human body. Human body is comprises of that 5 elements of nature. In this, every element have a little composition in which 70% is composite with the water. 70% composite of the water. So definitely we should realize that the 70% of the things that we should take has that much of water in it. If that much water is not there, definitely the body will lose its efficiency. I'm going to talk about it later, how it's work. So let's see that if I give an example there, like I'm living in my home there and my home is really dirty. I definitely not want to live there. So we can keep our psychology like that, human psychology is like that. A clean place is a better place to live. Okay, so like the same way, a clean body is a healthy body to live. If your body is clean from inside, definitely you have no problem. People think that they have got disease and they want to run to the doctor and they will get fine and cure there. But we never realize that nothing gets to the body from outside. Very rarely your body will get catches anything from outside. If you are weak from inside, then only. Whatever the things your body is rated, is you're putting with your own hands. You're eating the food, it's going down, and it's making everything chaos there without you realizing what's happening there. So we basically understand that nothing is getting inside through the body from outside. Whatever we put, whatever we choose to get it inside, that gives the nutrient or the health. So let's talk now, what is the nutrient a body should need? Because the yoga concept or the life concept is the prana, we should eat that have the life, okay? To get the life, you need to eat the life. What are the things that have the life? Now, this is the logic that you have to understand. Let's make our life go 200 years back or 100 years back, where our grandparents used to live. I have never find my grandmother doing dieting. She is amazingly fine. Touch wood. She's crossed 100 and she's living perfectly well. But what's her signs? Her science is that her lifestyle, what she was adopting or she has done till right now, she's fixed to that. What was the lifestyle that she's following right now from that time till that time? That's the thing I want you to make you understand. To get the life, you need to eat life. Earlier, I was to say there was no refrigerators, there were no processed food, there were no preservatives, there were no chemicals. So the food was never like that. So our body is made up of in a process that we should eat in the things that has nothing to deal with the processed thing. We should eat those things which can be directly consumed from the nature, I would say. The things that can go directly into the body, which doesn't require further process. The further processing doesn't require, like vegetables, fruits, or nuts, or cereals, bajra, gehun, rice without polish, dals without polish. That's the thing I'm talking about. Not sugar, not these processed salts and everything. Not even processed oils. Only the best thing that I have known for the oils and everything is the desi ghee or coconut oil. These are the things which cannot be processed. You can directly consume it, taken out, and you can use it there. So you have to understand why I tell to take this natural food is there, because this food can be digested. Your body is made to make this food digest very fast. Its organs, the organs are made like this. Now, even in this food, how you get the nutrients, you have to understand that there is a life of the food. You cook something, it has its own life. And this life, I would say, is not more than 3 hours. If I don't have any refrigerator, if I don't have any processing machine of keeping that food, you realize that food will die just within 3 hours to 4 hours. Now you can imagine the food that you're processing, the food which is not processed, that food digest in 3 hours. So people give the expiry of the food is like 2 years, some food 6 months, 3 months, or I would say 1 week. That kind of expiry when people give, that means that food has really something harm that can harm us in the future. Not right now, maybe later. Old people are the best examples or the inspiration to understand what is the concept of the life, to understand the life more better, because they have made their life in a better manner. Now, people who really wants to have to see the changes in themselves with the diet and everything, the first, there are 5 things that I want to tell in the yoga that I have done. I have, for 2 years, I have not taken salt, I have not taken the sugar, and I've really like pushed myself on understanding how it was there. It was long time back, around 5 to 6 years back, I have tried all these things because I was suffering from a disease, and that was really bad, you know. My stomach was not working well. I had insects in my stomach, and I was going with the depression and anxiety there. I have to work hard, really work hard on that. I will tell you how, what I have done. But right now, I wanted to make you realize, if you want to get results, what are the main key things? It's not about knowing everything. It's about what are the key things that really works. So, things that I've kept here is, the first thing in the yoga, it also says that discipline. Atha yoga anushasanam. Atha yoga anushasanam. To get yourself everything, you need the discipline. The second thing is the dedication. Dedication is the key that you really want that thing. It's not that it moves with your life. You have to put some extra efforts on it, definitely. And the consistency. It's not about doing today, not doing tomorrow, doing 1 month, not doing for 2 months, not like that. You have to be really consistent on the things if you want to see the result. And last and foremost things, I would say patience. Patience is the key. If someone has told, if I say you will get 100% results, it's the nature of the body that if you do everything nice, if you put it in the principles, you'll get 100% results. You have to be patient and you have to follow that thing. So it's not about following the diet chart. It's about following that lifestyle for a long time to see nice results in yourself. Like I have given 2 years, at least I want you to be consistent for 3 months, even when you want to try or when you want to start anything new there. And the second thing that I want to add in this here, yes, the second thing that I want to add, that body is not about having the food. It has its mechanism of having the food, getting the energy and cleansing inside. If the cleansing process is not going inside, if incoming is there and outgoing is not there, you'll definitely will be unhealthy. Now, let me tell you this part of the unhealthy things. We know that most of the times what we eat, and it's definitely not wholesome food. And the diet chart that I would recommend, that people always ask me, is that you need to realize that you are eating living. So if you're having the nice wholesome food that you're eating fresh fruits, vegetables, if you're eating dal, nuts, rice, and unpolished things, everything that could be consumed from the nature without further processing, it can be directly consumed. Your body is definitely healthy there. Now let's talk about that, how the body is composed. Body is composed, like I told, 70% it's composed with the water and other elements of nature, earth, water, fire, ether, wind, but 70% is water only. So we should take most of the food that has rich in water contents there. That food, I would say, digests very fast in the body. It gives you nice energy and it keeps your organs healthy. That thing will not stick into the body. Your intestine will not stick it. Now comes the point. If you think your lifestyle or the food habits that you were following, if it's closer to very much to the unhealthy food, which was a lot of processed with the oils, that things goes inside, it takes a lot of time to digest it, have less nutrients, I would say that less water inside or antioxidants in the food, definitely you realize you are putting a lot of garbage inside, and now this garbage is stinking. I would say that any dirty place will catch insects or false smell and everything. The same place gets with the body. Slowly and slowly, if we put false things in the body, it starts getting a garbage there and it will stick in intestine. If it gets stick in the intestine, what will happen? It will consume by the blood and the blood will become thicker or heavier. When the blood will become thicker and the heavier, it will rotate in the complete body. Then you might get problem in any part of the body, whether it's your brain, whether it's your heart, whether it's your lungs, whether it's your liver, whether it's your pancreas, your intestine, whether it's your urinary bladder, ureters, anything, fibroids, cysts, anything, just a form. It's just a part of toxins, or it's another form of toxins there. When these toxins get accumulated for the long time, definitely get the disease. If you want to make yourself healthy, I would say give a lot of time to rest to make your body healthy again. Your body needs rest to get healthy again. For that, I would say you have to maintain the timings. Timings are the really important part of the human healthy body. If you want to make yourself healthy, eat the food which are rich in antioxidants, which are naturally grabbed from the nature. Make the timings of it and make it balanced. The yoga concept or any Ayurveda concept is to make it balanced. You gotta make yourself to make it balanced inside the body. Plus, you have to make sure that whatever you are doing in a day has to be balanced. Like your work also, your food also, your sleeping also. Everything has to be balanced with it. Now, let me tell you the timing, the window timing, the window of the food. Our body is made up of, the food helps to digest only with the fire. So you have the window, like I've told before, when the morning, when the sun rises, the Jatharagni or the fire starts in the body. Then you have the window till the sunset. I would say till 6 o'clock is the maximum good time, or 7 is the maximum. I would say 6, only 6:30 is the maximum good time to have that window of the food. Now this is the window to have the food. Now, as soon as the sun's getting down and down, you have to make sure, realize you have to make the things that are less cold things has to go down. The cold things or any things that you want to have a juice, you have to salads, you have to the fruits, that thing can be consumed nice in the morning when the sun is up high. And when the sun is goes down nicely, then you can make yourself things little to the warmer part or hot part. Then also you have to take the things which are nicely rich in water. You can take a lot of nice vegetables filled with mixed with the water, and you cook it there. Like I used to take a lot of food that is filled with boiled water there. And I don't take roasted food, or I would say oil, or I don't eat spices. I don't like spices very much there. Sometimes that I have cheated myself, because I used to like pizza there long time back there, and from a long time I have not eaten that also. Now the next part is that I also got the disease and how I clean myself. The best part of the cleaning mechanism of the body is the fasting process, okay? Like today it's very famous, like intermediate fasting. It's nothing like fasting. It's like you are giving the body to re-health again. Your body is a master engineer of itself, and it's clean and it's heal itself again. So if you want to feel any changes in the body, if you have the fat, if you have any kind of fibroid, cyst, asthma, or I would say that if you have stomach issues, if you have pain or anything, then you have to make your body clean inside. And if your stomach is clean, if your blood is clean, if your intestine are clean, your body will heal fast. For this, I would say that minimum you should give 3 months a time. And the healing process takes in the body for 10 to 15 hours. So you need to keep yourself empty at that time. So if you eat the last food at 7:30, then you should keep your body empty till 9 o'clock in the morning next day or 10 o'clock in the morning next day to have that healing process. And from that, whenever you start eating there, then also you have to take the food which are consumable by the human body that are rich in water and rest of the antioxidants, or which can be consumed directly from the nature and without further processed. That food can be digested very fast. Now, you in the sattvic food also, we call it the food which is not made up of processing, which don't have spices very much, and which can have its own properties. Like fruits have their own taste, vegetables have its own taste, nuts and other grains have its own taste. Without putting any further processing in that, if you take that things nicely, either you can boil it or consume it directly, that will give you health. That will give you any results that you want in the body. And I would say that if you want to experiment yourself, try to make your diet in such a manner that is made up of wholesome food with fruits, vegetables, nuts, grains, and balance it with the timing. I've told the timings of that. You have to make it. There are 3-4 things that people ask me about the constipation and bloating and everything. You have to understand for that if you maintain the timings very well, and if you if you're not taking anything which is very cold, definitely your body will be healthy. You never had that kind of problem there. Only thing, you have to make sure that your body doesn't take yourself cold stuff. Never take the things out of the refrigerators, or never take things for the 2 or 3 days frozen and then eat it there. If your body was doing all these practices from a long time, taking cold water, sleeping in the AC and everything, definitely your body will get affected by those things. I think I've made a lot of things there, and let me see if I have anything left there. Okay, I think that's the thing. And if you really want that, you should ask that what you should eat from morning till evening, what anaj you should take, or what grains you should take, what vegetables or fruit you should take, then I will make a separate video for this. I just want to make you realize here, to make you realize what is the science of the food and how your body is composed, so that you can understand yourself and definitely to see changes for yourself. Okay, the video is getting a little longer there, so I'm gonna post it on the YouTube and a little bit on the Instagram, so you can understand yourself. If you have any questions still left, you can ask me there. Okay, but please, if you want to see the result, definitely you have to give time to yourself. Your body has its own engineering and mechanism. You have to live by the principles of the body, and definitely get 100% result. Everything can be cured just by the simple fact what you should eat, how you should eat, what time you should eat, and making yourself better with it. Okay, thanks for watching the video, everyone. See you there tomorrow. Next time. Bye bye.